I love the garden experience because you all sang your carols beautifully. But boy, joy to the world, Jeremiah was a bullfrog, had a whole different feel to it. So I kind of like Jeremiah the bullfrog and the baby Jesus all put together. That's a good mix. I like that. So what we were doing here today is kind of traditional Christmas caroling, which really kind of started around the 13th century. But then the Protestant Reformation came in, and we realized not only could we share a message, but we could have a lot of fun doing it. And so for hundreds of years now, people have caroled throughout the streets and the holidays times and holiday celebrations. Actually, it started as part of the winter solstice. So we are part of that great tradition here today, and in fact, some of us went caroling even this week, and it's just something about singing, isn't there? There's just something about singing. You can't really be angry and sing, can you? You know, you just can't sing a good Christmas carol and be angry. What you need to do, what was that? Alanis Morissette. I know I was also thinking, well, maybe, you know, but we're not going to go there. A Christmas carol. You can't be angry and sing a Christmas carol. So my question to you today is, number one, how's the singing going? Have you been doing any singing this December season? 105.7, you might be over it by now, but I just discovered it earlier in the week. How many of you have been just really singing? Because singing produces joy, a feeling of great pleasure and happiness. So if you haven't been singing, then what is it in your life that is bringing you joy right now? This is the question I want us to ponder this morning. What brings joy in your life? And the second part of the question is, and what are you doing about it? We have been gifted with just like five more days here to explore the joy of Christmas. And I don't know about you, but I experienced a great deal of joy, not only with the beautiful voices that were up here, but even the voices that were out there singing to us, the little voices out there singing to us. You know, sometimes we forget to listen to those little voices. I went to Target yesterday in preparation for this message, looking for those joyful little voices, and I found some. I found some other ones that perhaps weren't so joyful, but do you know what? They were certainly letting people know how they were feeling at the moment. Where do we lose that? Where do we lose that ability? Where do we become so adult that we forget to be angry and we get to forget to be joyful? So for the next few days, I want you to do me a favor and kind of come down a little and take a look and see what's happening in the other world that exists in the same place we are. I want you to do me a favor and take a moment and look at the world through the eyes of a Sophie. Sophie's about this tall. Take a moment and look through the world through the eyes of a teenager. And just pause and see what brings them joy. And then ask yourself, am I reflecting the same thing back to them? Am I reflecting what joy means at 50? Am I reflecting what joy means at 60? Am I reflecting the joy of having life and breath and movement in everything I do? Yesterday at Target, there was that Olaf guy, and he stood about this big. Isn't that his name? Olaf. He's a snowman? Yes. I saw him yesterday. And there was someone who was even smaller than Olaf, standing next to Olaf. And he was probably barely walking, but he just stood there, and in front of everybody went, "Go!" And he did it again. "Go!" I think that, is it "Let It Go" or something like that? Every parent is going, "Yes, don't. Go!" And then sure enough was a grandmother who thought it was the most beautiful sound she had ever heard in her entire life with the camera right there. Friends, take place of that grandmother, take that place of that little person. And just sing out the joy of the season. I can guarantee you, no matter what's going on in your life, no matter how many challenges you are facing, there is something joyful, maybe not in your life, but happening around you. You have to look for it. You have to look for it. There is great joy in children. I've always said that I never had kids, but actually I've had lots of kids because I believe that God calls all of us to parent all children and to ensure that all children experience some sense of joy. If you encounter a kid this week that you don't think is experiencing joy, first pray for them and then simply ask that they know the joy and the love that will not let them go. Also be mindful that there are still kids in this city and in this world who don't know the joy of having enough to eat, who don't know the true joy of the season. And lots of people have worked very hard to ensure that everyone can experience the joy of the season. But we're not going to give up until every child does. Today, be mindful of where your heart is on the journey. Is your heart two times too small, or is it filled to overflowing? No matter where you are, today is an opportunity to find joy. Take a look at this next clip.